How many of you have had a favorite childhood book read to you every night? Some of you may have been classics such as Goodnight Moon. Others maybe had a pre-calculus textbook. In the real world, there are stories lying all around us just waiting to be read. Stories of a different time where before electricity, regular water running, and technology such as our phones. Scary, right? I grew up in a historical household. Everything pretty much revolved around history. Every night before bed, my mom would tell me this story about the city, about how it's changed over time. One story really stuck with me. That our neighbor's house in the 1930s was an extravagant mansion, and on this day, it is a slab of concrete sticking out of the grass. I probably would not be standing here today if it wasn't for my mother. She taught me to love history and appreciate the world around us. Over the past 3 years, I've been working at the Landmark Society of Western New York on a project dealing with their slides. A slide is a strip of film, practically. It was used for photos back in the day before being replaced by digital technology, such as our phones and all. While phones are preferred today because it's easy to send photos to one another, slides hold a very special place in their hearts. Slides are arguably more crisper. And they're very small and easy to pocket, per se. But what's problematic with them is it's difficult to transfer these slides to one another at different agencies. You have to literally go in a slide cabinet, pull out the slides, put them in an envelope, and send them to people. What my project's doing is to digitalize these, get them online, so we as a collective may see them. I want to play a game with you all. It requires your participation. You don't have if you don't want to, but it's encouraged. How many of you recognize this building by a show of hands? It's a fair number, yeah. Midtown Plaza was arguably the first indoor mall, 1959. As of now, it's a husk of a building, which I believe it's going to become apartment buildings, but nothing is certain. How many of you rode the monorail there? That was so many good memories. There's not going to be any more of that. The only record that the Midtown Plaza was Midtown Plaza, or in photos like these. How about this one? Yeah, not as many hands as I thought. Some of you may recognize the structure as the War Memorial, home of the sporting teams such as the Amerks, the Nighthawks, the Razor Sharks. And when you go to this site now, you're wondering, where's my seat? What aisle am I in? Where's the rink? Back in the day, constructed in the 1840s, this was a tobacco factory, the Kimball Tobacco Factory. You can see in the distance the famous statue of Mercury, which you may see today. It was on the Kimball Tobacco Factory. How about this? This is Lower Falls. Lower Falls in Rochester, New York, 1788 looked like this. If you tried to find Rochester on a map in 1788, you would get stuck. Rochester was virtually nada at this point. This painting was painted as a first sighting. Imagine you're an explorer walking through the forest covered in mosquitoes and filth, and you get to this beautiful sight of a fall. A lot of people think that Rochester was a lake town, built on the lake, Lake Ontario, sea breeze, yeah. Actually, it's a river town. The Genesee River is the main reason Rochester became as big as it did, and the Erie Canal. Last one. How many of you recognize this building? This is where we are today, Allendale Columbia, 1969. You saw the courtyard walking up today with 2 feet of snow covered on it. In 1966, Allendale Columbia had a fire that destroyed most of its buildings. You could really tell how new it is just by looking at these plants, the freshly planted birch trees. As of today, the birch trees are the school symbol. So, in 1937, Helen L. Wanger brought a group of people together to save the building in gray, the Campbell Whittlesey House. If you've been driving towards Buffalo and you've looked to the left, just past the Susan B. Anthony Bridge, you would see this beautiful building built in the 1830s. You're probably wondering, what museum is that? This is a residence. In 1937, this building was run down and was facing demolition because they wanted to build a parking lot over it. A group of people came together to save this building. And to this day, it is still a residence. This became one of the first historical societies in all of the United States. They've been working countlessly for 80 years to educate and to protect our history. In 1991, the rundown building on the screen right here in Cornhill was facing demolition, similar to the Campbell Whittlesey House. It is not 50 yards from that building, and it was facing demolition as well. The Landmark Society saved that building and turned it into their headquarters, where they are today. What I've been doing at the Landmark Society of Western New York is digitalizing their slide collection. 80,000 slides are on record there of approximately 30,000 different individual buildings. I talked to my boss about why does she do slide talks to educate people, and it's simply because they haven't digitalized their slides. Everything is done the old-fashioned way. Literal slide talks. She would go to the slides, pick them out individually, and put them in a slide carousel and display them for crowds like such as you to educate. They want something more convenient, something like where they can send this information to one another, and they can send it to counties all across the state for references of architecture design. 50% of the images, 40,000 approximately, are of the city of Rochester. It only makes sense because we started in Rochester, and it's easy to go 5 miles and 50 miles. But that doesn't mean other counties are on record. The rest of 25% of the images, such as Henrietta, Pittsford, are represented on these slides as well. 61 counties in New York State in total are represented. Other counties you may recognize, Chemung County, where Elmira is, or Bronx County, where the Bronx is. But there are mainly 9 counties they focus on. When you look at some of these images on the slides, I notice there are the letters DEM, which stands for demolished. When a building is gone, it's gone. The people who have memories of that building are going to be the only people who do. There's not going to be any more memories of that building left eventually. The only evidence that these buildings even existed are these slides. You may recognize this is demolished in the 1950s, but this is the Claude Bragdon train station. The RMSC, famous science museum on East Avenue, right next door had an observatory right to it. This was taken in the 1930s. Some of the windows, you can tell, are boarded up. This building was demolished shortly after this photo was taken. In 2013, Wegmans on East Avenue took out a whole block of 1920s buildings to establish a large Wegmans. These buildings are lost forever. And lastly, Rochester's new Costco was built on the Iola campus on Westfall Road, which used to be a tuberculosis sanitarium. The point is, eventually, when buildings are lost, we forget that those buildings ever existed because we become used to seeing what's there now instead of what was there before. Landmarks portray a story that no person can tell. Buildings are more than just brick, stone, and mortar. They are the heart and souls of people of a different era. Eras without phones, eras without electricity and running water. This picture I have up here is a plat map of 1871 of the city of Rochester. I didn't choose this because it was the first result in Google Images or because it was on my flash drive. But I chose this because it really illustrates a good point. If you've ever seen anatomical studies of the human body, if you've ever seen pictures of a nerve cells, they transfer information to one another, such as like a hit or a slap or a burn. What Rochester has its pride in the achievements of, such as Kodak, Xerox, Bausch & Lomb, it projects to the rest of the world. It transfers from one cell to the next. On a smaller scale, individual landmarks serve as nerve cells of their own. They portray to us their history, the times that were different. In 100 years' time, what I say is only going to be remembered by a recording. My word, the only people who will be remembered, there will be nobody left to remember my words. The only record of me saying anything will be a recording. Buildings are the same. There are going to be no people left in our era. But hopefully, with buildings left from our era, people may understand what life was like for us. I close my speech in the words of Alfred de Vigny. History is the novel for which people are the author. Thank you.